My name's Austin Larabee. I'm a captain paramedic with Sierra Vista Fire Medical Services out of Sierra Vista, Arizona. It's in southern Arizona, about 10 miles north of the Mexico line and about an hour south of Tucson. And here today, we'll be talking about the Pierce truck that we're going with. 107-foot stick. We call it a truck. So this will be truck 202. It'll go on our station 2. The reason kind of we go with at least an aerial apparatus, we want at least one truck company in our city, which is this is it, and kind of the whole area. We also serve some partners, automatic aid, and so this is the truck company of Sierra Vista, pretty much. Bumper-wise, some of the big things that we like the Federal. Everybody, that's kind of a request from everybody, so we try to throw a Federal on everything. We do like to have a bumper line here. We use this a lot for roadside fires, car fires, dumpster fires, something we can get to quickly. Usually just do 100 feet out of that. Something else that we really like and we've had on prior trucks is the spotlight up top, remote controlled. A lot of people don't designate their house numbers very well, so we use that a lot. So that's something that a lot of the guys like and we want it on there. And of course the American flag looks good. Something that is new that we haven't used and we're going to be trying on this truck is these side cameras. Got a side camera on each side. Kind of a big complaint of some of these bigger trucks is the blind spots on our left and right side. So I think that's going to come in handy for all of us, especially all our engineers. We like the TAC 4 independent suspension. Trucks that we've had that on and trucks that we haven't, we definitely like the TAC 4 suspension system on these. A lot smoother, ride nice. A couple things we did different with this build than some of our other rigs is we just did our two ride and back seats for SCBAs, Firewise, and then we left these seats over here open. So we kind of have an EMS side and then a fire side. So then we kind of get away with guys sitting in seats all the time with the packs in their back and accidents and stuff like that. So we also went with a custom cabinet there in the middle for our drug box and some of our equipment, our four gas meters, our cardiac monitor. So we just figure going with that, we can protect things a little bit, especially from the heat in Arizona. One of the big changes for us on this, we use this considerably more than a truck company, but an engine company, so that's why we went with the 500-gallon tank. And something we really wanted on this that we didn't have on any other aerials was a foam system. Like I said, we use this more as an engine company, so we wanted that versatility of having foam on there for anything that we might need. So that's something new for us that we're looking forward to having. And we run two crosslays, 1¾ inch, and then a crosslay 2½. For our bin up here, our dunnage space, we like to put a lot of our stuff that doesn't get used as much, like our hazmat stuff, swift water gear, kitty litter, our roadside supplies. So it still makes it pretty easy. You can hop up there on the side and grab that stuff out. So that makes it nice. A little extra storage space. Something also a little different for us this go around is using the lap doors. We've been trying to get away from the roll-up doors, so this is going to be a little experiment for us to see if guys are going to like them or we go back to a roll-up door, but I really like them. I like the sturdiness of them, and so I think we're going to like it. We did a lot of roll-out trays. Just makes it easier for folks getting stuff out, getting stuff back in, back injuries. So we've noticed the rollout trays are a lot better on us, so we put rollout trays in all of our compartments. So our big wide compartments, this side, we put all of our EMS supplies in here, our trauma bags, medical bags, peds, all that good stuff. So that makes it easy for us to firefighter to hop out and grab all that stuff out of here for EMS calls. This rig we did a little something different as well. We just went with one side of steps. One issue you always run into is not enough space to put stuff. So this truck, we went with just one set of steps And you'll see when we get to the other side why we did that for compartment space and being able to store more gear on the truck. We've got two hose beds up here as well. So we've got a space for 800 feet of 4-inch. That's what we use for our water supply. And then we also have 450 feet of 2.5 for another fire, 2.5-inch firefighting line on the rear force. And then you'll have our ladder complements, pipe poles, 24, 16, 2 16s, and then our 35 and a 10. And then we also have another 14 up on the ladder. Another plus I like on this thing is our rear steps, which I like. I'm not the tallest lad in the world, so this is something that we hadn't had on anything else. So I think we're gonna really like that, being able to hop up here, have a little bit better advantage of getting that hose down off the truck, make it a little bit safer. So I definitely like that for sure. So this is a little bit different for us as well. On this apparatus, you have the two stabilizer arms on the side, but this one has a center stabilizer mount underneath the truck, which is gonna be good for us. We do have some places where we get into some rough terrain, tight spots, so that's gonna be nice for us as well. The controls for each side, the rear stabilizer can be controlled on either side, so you can finish it up with that, and then your manual controls here for emergency backup. So you'll be able to tell here, one of the reasons we went just with one step on the side of the truck is it gave us a lot more space for saws, extrication equipment. We also use these for, we carry a low-rise pack and a high-rise pack, so any of our hose extensions, that's what we'll throw in here, which is nice because we've had a lot of problems with trying to get it to fit into compartments, cram them in there, and then they're hard to get out, so I think this is gonna be good for us. And again, you can see another slide-out tray down here, make life a little bit easier. So I do like the room that created, just going with the one ladder. Middle compartment. Went with a little tool board backing, so that's where we're gonna throw all of our tools, forcible entry tools, commercial tools, so we'll get all those pinned up onto that backboard, which makes things pretty nice. And two nice long compartments so we can get everything in there all in one place. One thing we did a little bit different is our pedals up here for the sirens. We noticed a lot of times when they get put down on the floor, they get broken, we kick them, we break them. So that's something new. We had them put up on the dash there, so it's kind of out of the way and you can just tap it with your hand when you want to change it. You don't really have to take your eyes off anything, and which is something a little bit new. So it'll be interesting to see how the guys like that. And I can tell too, there's a little bit more room in this officer seat. Our other truck that we have is pretty tight and hard to get dressed. So I'm happy about that. We've been, same with our graphics. After this truck, finally we've gotten to where all of our trucks look similar, paint schemes, so which I think looks good driving up and down the road. Light-wise, just gone red and blues. We did change it up a little bit. You'll see on the side down there with our scene lighting, we went with a long, elongated light bar, so it'll be interesting to see how that looks for us. There are a lot of spots that we do need a lot of light where we're at, so it'll be interesting to kind of see how those new light bars work out for us. I'd just like to thank Pierce again for building us an awesome truck. We're gonna get it out today, run it through its paces, see how she runs, see how she does. Also I'd like to thank my family back home, my wife Tanya, and my kids Taylor and Tyson, and all the guys back at Sierra Vista Fire Medical Services. Thank you.